गुड आफ्टरनून एस के गुप्ता सर. ओके सो अ वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू आवर पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु हैव जॉइंड टुडेज वेबिनार एंड अलोंग विद दैट वी वुड लाइक टू वेलकम आवर फैकल्टी फॉर टुडेज वेबिनार श्री एस के गुप्ता सर. देन बिफोर वी गो ऑन टू स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज वेबिनार आई वुड लाइक टू विश ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स अ वेरी हैप्पी लोरी. टुडे इज द डे विच इज सेलिब्रेटेड एज इट मार्क्स द एंड ऑफ द विंटर्स एंड द स्टार्ट ऑफ द स्प्रिंग. And it is celebrated as a harvest festival. So this is usually a typically celebrated festival in the north. But nevertheless, would like to extend the warm wishes to all the participants on this occasion. That's Happy Lohri. Then we move ahead to today's webinar. A very interesting, very informative, and very important webinar, which I'm sure all the participants are very keen to listen to our today's speaker, Shri S. K. Gupta sir. As we all know that the government consolidated all the central labor laws into the four codes, and this is going to be made effective from the coming April 2021. And the four laws which are included are the wage code, the industrial relations code, the social security code, the occupational safety, health and working conditions codes. And there are a lot many changes in key terms, definitions, classifications, provisions which have been made. And along with that, the old terminologies have been replaced by new terminologies, which has made the work quite simpler, and it has helped in avoiding confusions. And nevertheless, it has got a uniformity amongst the different laws. By initiating the labor reforms, the government has taken an important step, which is expected to make the Indian economy, which is more productive, more competitive, and which will ease our businesses. While the government is presently is in the process of framing the and drafting the rules and finalize it shortly, there are a lot of professional bodies, and we are very thankful to Shri S.K. Gupta sir, who has agreed to our request and who is here to facilitate us about one important code, which is the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Conditions Code 2020. As we all know that the Road Safety Week is being celebrated across India, and along with that, there are a lot of awareness programs which has been conducted in RCF for our employees. So along with road safety, we realize that safety at the safety work conditions are very much important in the manufacturing unit. So this topic is of utmost importance to all the participants. And once again, we would request S.K. Gupta sir to facilitate us on this topic. Before I invite him, we will quickly go through his achievements and his profile. Shri S.K. Gupta sir presently is the advocate of Supreme Court. He has done his LLB and his PG diploma in labor laws and labor relations from the Aligarh Muslim University. Mr. Gupta started his career by serving reputed Indian manufacturing organizations, worked with Modi Continental and JK Tires. He served both the organizations in the capacity of HR head, dealing with personal industrial relations and legal functions for about 23 years. On inspiration of...
Very happy New Year to all and Lohri Festival to all participants. Now I'm going to start my this webinar by presenting. Can you, madam...
Yes, sir.
Allow me to option for sharing.
Sorry, sir.
Kindly allow me... Sharing option.
Yes, sir. I have removed my sharing. So you can just put your PPT and put it as share.
Host disabled participant screen sharing.
Yeah. And there is a humble request to all the participants that to please keep your audios on mute. And in case of any questions if there are during the session, you can put it in the chat box, which we can take it towards the end.
Madam, my PPT is visible?
No, sir, it is not visible.
No, actually, kindly allow me to share.
Sir,
disabled.
I have made you the co-host, sir.
But actually, this message is showing. Yes, now. It is now. Okay, madam. Now it's done. Yes, very correct. Now it is visible?
Yes, it is visible, sir.
Very correct. So now, thanks to all, I'm going to start webinar, the Occupational Safety and Health and Working Condition Code 2020. In short, it is called OHSW Code 2020. Okay. Now, Yes. Basically, you are all aware that this Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Code was enacted on 28th September 2020, because that day the President of India has given an assent. But still, this has not been notified by the central government, because under the code, there is also provision under Section 1(3) that the central government may notify whole code or some provision of this code. Recently, you are very much aware that the code on wages, which was assent was given in August 2019, only one provision, that is a Section 42, was notified by the central government on 18th December 2020. So like that, this power has been given by the legislature to notify the total code, or they are also may plan to notify few section or the few chapter on any month. Tentatively, the Ministry of Labor has planned to codify or to notify all the four code on 1st April 2021. Okay. Now, as you are also aware that these are the four code, okay, for which the central government is going to reform. Okay. The first code is code on wages, and under that, the four act, old act, or the present act, it is going to be merged. That is a Payment of Wages Act, Minimum Wages Act, and Payment of Bonus and Equal Remuneration. And the Industrial Relation Act, which we are going to take on 15th of this month. And these, only the three old or the present act is going to be merged under the Industrial Relation Code, that is a Trade Union, Industrial Employment Standing Order and Industrial Dispute Act. And another is the code Social Security Act. Nine present act is going to be merged. That is Employee Compensation, Employee State Insurance, Employee Provident Fund, Employee Employment Exchange, Maternity Benefit, Payment of Gratuity, Sign Workers Welfare Fund, and Building and Other Construction Work, and the Unorganized Workers Social Security Act. Now, today we are going to take the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition, and under that code 13 present act, it is going to be merged. Prima facie that they have drafted very effectively. So actually one can understand properly and can also implement across the country or across the industry. That is a one, this 13 code, one is the FACTI Act. That is the main act under this occupational safety. Then plantation, mine, working journalist fixation rate of wages, motor transport workers act, bidi and cigar workers, and the contract evolution act. Because actually the FACTI Act and another the contract act, these are the very important provision, and they have government has reformed in very to ease doing business. Okay, so the FACTI Act and the Contract Act, very good. Actually, they have taken a very good initiative to give a benefit to the industries. Okay, sign workers and theater workers and the dog workers Safety, Health and Welfare Act 1946, and the Building and Other Construction Act 1996. So these are 13 act is going to be merged, and now it is called Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition 2020. Okay. Now, how this act is going to be applicable? So there is a only rider of 10%. That is a very important, because the establishment, because this act is going to implement not only the factory. Okay. This is very important. It is going to implement in respect of the establishment. On which establishment? The having a 10 or more workers अब नाउ द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एस्टेब्लिशमेंट इज गिवन इंडस्ट्री मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑक्यूपेशन ऑडियोविजुअल प्रोडक्शन ट्रेड मोटर ट्रांसपोर्ट अंडरटेकिंग बिल्डिंग एंड अदर कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क बिजनेस न्यूज़पेपर एस्टेब्लिशमेंट एंड प्लांटेशन ओके तो दीज आर नाइन विल बी कॉल्ड एज एस्टेब्लिशमेंट एंड वेयर 10 आर मोर पर्सन मोर वर्कर आर वर्किंग दैट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज ए establishment and all provision of this OHS code will be applicable. Now, second actually is the factory apply on 20 and 40. Right now, our old act says 10 or 20. Now, this threshold limit has been increased from 10 to 20 and 20 to 40. Our working in manufacturing process, otherwise the definition of the same they have taken. Okay, like that. Now, establishment hazardous industry are required to minimum even a 1%. So now what will happen? The second rider has been fixed by the central government. If any hazardous industry, then the threshold limit of 10% or you can call it 20 or 40 will not be applicable. Even a 1% is working that industry that will be covered under the OHS code. The code applied to mines dock without threshold limit. Okay. There is no need. If you less than 10, it will be applicable. Code does not apply to the office of the central or state government or any ship of war. However, the code apply in case of contract labor employed through contractor in the office of the central or the state government. Okay. This is important. The code apply in case of contract employed through contractor in the office of the central government. It means if the central government is going to take any services of the contractors, then this code will also applicable. Now, definition, because under section 2 of every act, it is going to tell for the purpose of interpretation, that is a definition. Okay. So I have taken a important definition. Okay. What multiple overlapping definition to explain who is employed person. Now, very important addition was done by the central government, core activities. Okay. What are the core activities? Establishment, which I have already narrated definition of establishment. And the definition of the factory, interstate migrant worker, okay. And the manufacturing, what is the definition of manufacturing? Multiple definition, employer, occupier, and owner. And definition of wages, okay. So these are the important definition which we are going to take these in our subsequent presentation. Now, definition of appropriate government is also very important. Why actually I am saying? Because actually, for your company, appropriate government is the central government, okay? And other than central government on company are the company which is going to be supervised by the central government, okay? Then last May, it is mentioned that the state government shall be appropriate government in respect of following establishments situated within the state, okay? So now actually there is a two bifurcation done by the government. One is the appropriate central government will be appropriate government for those industry which is being managed by the central government. For the other industry, the state government. That is the my interpretation. Okay. Now, multiple definition for the person employed in establishment, audiovisual workers, okay, building workers, contract labor, employee, interstate migrant worker, and motor transport worker, and sales promotion employee worker, and working journalist. So these are the definition given, okay, because they have merged all the Act 13 Act. So actually they have covered a definition like building construction, journalist, and like that, okay. Now, definition of employee is important because whenever there is a dispute, then it is coming ke who will be called worker or who will be called employee. Yes, sir. Am I audible properly? Yes. Okay. Now, employee definition. What actually, who will be treated as employee? Employee means include person employed managerial, administrative, supervisory capacity, also without any link to the salary limit. Okay. It means whosoever working managerial, administrative, supervisory without any salary rider. Okay. Now definition of worker includes the worker working in managerial administrative capacity or working as a supervisor drawing exceeding 18,000 okay per month. This however may cause confusion given that the definition of worker in the code of wages 2019 upper limit salary and exclusion of the person from the ambit of worker is prescribed 15,000 means when this code was enacted in 2019, the salary rider under the code is given 15,000. But I can specifically, I'm going to clear on the rider of this salary limit. Actually, as far as my experience or the Supreme Court judgment, this salary rider is not applicable for deciding factor of the worker. Why I am saying? Because the pilot of the airlines, he is getting a salary right now on average 2 lakhs rupees or 3 lakhs rupees per month. But under the definition of workman, the old act, he is a workman, which has been now called is worker now. So I can say like that, that the salary rider is not a criteria to decide the designation or the definition of the worker. Okay. And second actually hai nomenclature. Okay. Or designation. Okay. Both are also not important to decide the definition of worker because only the nature of duty is going to decide whether that person coming under the definition of workman or worker or not. So that is the important. Now I am saying nature of duty because at the bottom I have already written the true test in the nature of duty and function performed by the individual person. Okay. So these are the citation decided by the Supreme Court that one of the Glaxo and another SK Mani, okay, Burma Sale, okay, Sandoz. So these are the decided case of the Supreme Court, which clearly they have made a settled law that the true test is the nature of duty or the function performed by the workman. The salary rider or you can call it that designation is not a criteria. Now, another actually the change of the worker definition, what is happening, employee and worker. Earlier, trainee was excluded from the purview of employee and worker both. Okay. But now the trainee is the worker and employee. Okay. Now only what excluded, only the any worker or employee is going to be recommended by the state government under the Apprentice Act. Okay. For giving a training. Then that apprentice is excluded from the purview of employee as well as the worker category. So I can say last word that whosoever is coming inside the company except the apprentice will be called either employee or worker. Now definition of the occupier or the owner. Employer under section 21U. Occupier under section 21ZS and owner is under section 21ZW. And who is the employer now? The legislation has given a very wide amplitude to definition and it will take into the ambit the following person as employer. Occupier of the factory. The person, the company is going to be nominated as an occupier under the Factory Act. So that will be treated as a employer, owner of the mind, and person with ultimate control over the affairs of the establishment, contractor. Earlier, it was not included in the old act. Now, under this new definition of employer, contractor will also be treated employer and legal representative of the disease employer. So now I can say only the addition as compared to the old definition of the employer, contractor is added in this present scenario. Now, definition of occupier is very important for the FACTI Act and OHS code. Okay. Now, for saying like that, the occupier of FACTI shall be a person that is a ultimate control over the affairs of the company. Okay. So now, when this matter came before the Supreme Court in the JK Industry versus Chief Inspector of the FACTI AIN 1996 Supreme Court, wherein Supreme Court clearly defined that the occupier can only be nominated under the FACTI Act who is having a control over the affairs of the company, even the director, okay, designated director cannot be nominated as an occupier, only the person who is having a ultimate control over the affairs of the industry can be nominated as an occupier. Okay. So in case of the company, one of the director except independent director, that will be important. In case of the factory on control by the government, the person appointed to manage the affairs of the factory shall be deemed to be occupier. So in very simple, that the working director who is having a control over affairs of the company can only be nominated as an occupier. Okay. Now, what is the core activities? This is again important. Every industry, they are having a core activities. Like in textile industry, you know, manufacturing of the textile, that is the core activity. But the other activities will be treated as a non-core activities. So now what is correctly definition of core activity has been provided in the code to define the primary activity for which the establishment is set up and include any activity which is essential or necessary to such activities. So now definition excludes the following activities if the establishment is not set up for such activities, namely number one. So that is called non-core activities. Okay. This is a newly added provision. And for that, actually, contract can also be given for non-core activities. First of the activities is sanitation work, including sweeping, cleaning, dusting, collection, and disposal of all kind of the waste. That is a non-core activity. Watch and ward services, including the security services, canteen and catering services, loading, unloading operation, running of hospital, educational training institute, guest house, club, like where they are in the nature of support service of the establishment, courier service, which are in the nature of support service of the establishment, civil and other construction worker, including maintenance, gardening and maintenance of lawn and other like activities, housekeeping, laundry services, other like activities where there are in the nature of support service of an establishment, transport services, including ambulance services, any activities of intermittent nature over if the constitute a core activities of the establishment. So the importance of this non-core activities is only because these, for this purpose, the company can give a contract through contract employee. Okay. The purpose is automatically provision employment of contract labor in the core activities subject to the few exceptions under section 57. Okay. Now, definition of establishment. Okay. I have already explained before starting this webinar that establishment where any industry, trade, business, manufacturing, occupation is carried out, which is 10 or more employee are employed. Motor transport, factory, and mines. Mines, actually, there is no threshold limit. Okay, the establishment including a place carrying hazardous activities notwithstanding minimum threshold limit of the worker. Establishment includes a mine dock without threshold limit of the worker. Okay, so this is the very wide definition has been given of the establishment. Definition of factory, only they have increased the rider of person. Presently actually 10 or 20. Now they have increased from 10 to 20 and 20 to 40. So this is the only change. Okay. Now what actually they have changed? Where on 20 or more are working manufacturing process carried out on with the aid of power and without aid of power 40. Okay. So, but does not include which factory does not include like a mobile unit belonging to the armed force of the union, railway running shed, hotel, restaurant, and eating place. Okay. Installation, electronic data process unit, computer unit in any premises shall not be constituted as a factory if no manufacturing process is carried out on such premises. Okay. So this is the definition. Only the rider, they have increased the number of person 10 to 20 and 20 to 40. Nothing has been changed. Okay. Now manufacturing process and hazardous process. The term manufacturing process is defined under clause 2(1)(ZI) of the code to include various processes such as making, altering, repairing, ornamenting, finishing, packing, oiling, washing, pumping, generating power, composing, printing, constructing, breaking of the ship, storing article in the cold store, etc. And such other process as notified by the central government, because central government is having a power to include or exclude subsequently. Now, what is the hazardous process? Means any process or activity specified in the first schedule of the code. So, what actually first schedule? At the end of the this code, you will find that the first schedule, they have given the list which activities will come under the hazardous process. It may cause material impairment to the health of the person engaged in or connected therewith or result in the pollution of the general environment. Okay. Now, this is again, because this is the newly added provision, interstate migrant worker. Okay. So they have made very good law on this interstate migrant labor because during the pandemic, the government has faced a lot of managing this interstate migrant workers. So they made a very good law after deliberation or after having an experience of this pandemic. What actually interstate migrant includes a person has been recruited directly, indirectly through contractor in one state for employment in such establishment situated another establishment. Like actually if a person is going from the host country, okay, to the another host state to another state, that person will be treated as a interstate migrant labor. Now, what is going on? Second rider is this, up to the salary of 18,000, if any interstate migrant, then that person will come under the definition of state migrant labor. So there is only two rider. The person should go to another to work to another state, that will come, and another actually if he is getting a salary more than 18,000, up to 18,000, that person will come under this definition of interstate migrant worker. Now definition of industry. Basically, actually, they have designed or legislated this definition of industry based on one of the judgment, Bangalore Water Supply and Sewage Board versus Rajappa, 1978 AIR. So now, actually, they have what they say, any systematic activities carried on by cooperation between an employer and worker for the production, supply, distribution, goods, service with a view to satisfy human wants or wishes. So that is the, will be called industry. Whether or not, naturally the question is coming, any capital has been invested for the purpose of carrying such activity, or such activities is carried on the motive to make any profit or gain. It means it is not compulsory. Now, what actually they have excluded or does not include, institute owned by the organization in charitable social services. If any actually like just a temple hai, gurdwara hai, these are not included for the as coming under the definition, are the activities of the central government or the state government. Okay, any domestic service, okay, that will not treat it as a industry. Any other activities notified by the central government. Okay, so otherwise actually nowadays, as per the various decision of the, even the mandir is also coming under the definition of industry. Okay, and the institute also coming under the definition of industry. Now these has been excluded by virtue of this definition. Now wages, the definition of wages is very important, because nowadays in every print media and this electronic media, they are telling that the wages is going to be the take home salary is going to be reduced. Okay, so that's why actually the definition is very important. Or on which component the employer is liable to deduct provident fund, ESI, or on which component the bonus is going to be calculated, or the gratuity. So that actually is very important. So now actually the first part, which is given at the top, all remuneration, whether by way of salary, allowance, or otherwise, which would be payable under the terms of employment and includes basic pay, dearness allowance, retaining allowance. So it means actually three rider has been fixed for the definition of wages. Okay, first is the basic pay, another is the dearness allowance, and third one is retaining allowance. So in respect of the basic pay and dearness allowance is very clear, everybody is knowing. And in respect of the retaining allowance, that is only applicable for those industry who are running seasonal basis, like sugar industry. So during the retaining period, the to retain the workman, the some percentage of salary is also given to the employee. So that is called retaining allowance. Okay. Now what actually excluded? Any statutory bonus, A. B, the value of the house accommodation or supply of light, medical attendant or amenity, including the wages by a general or a special order. C, employee contribution to pension or provident fund and the interest accrued thereon. D, any conveyance allowance or the value of the traveling. E, any sum paid to the defray special expenses, house rent allowance, remuneration payable under award or settlement, overtime, any commission payable to the employee. Okay. And J, any gratuity payable on the termination of employee, any retrenchment compensation or the retirement benefit, or ex gratia payment to the. Now what actually they have fixed the another rider under the definition. Kindly read at the bottom. If the payment made A to I exceed 50%, or such other payment as notified by the central government, all of the remuneration calculated under this clause, the amount which exceeds such one half shall be deemed as a remuneration and shall accordingly to added in the first part. Now, just to understand the definition of wages, it means the cost to the company. You have to divide into two part. For 51% should go as the base category, and the 49% is goes to the allowances, different allowances. But under that allowances, my advice to the employer and the company, whenever you are going to give any allowances to their employee, you have to make the written policy why you are paying these allowances. Because actually, there's a like statutory bonus. There is no need to make the policy because it is already under the code on wages. All procedure is written. And second, the value of house accommodation. Most of the company, the government industry, or the even a private industry, they are also providing their own company quarter to the employee. So you have to make the policy who is entitled to get the house accommodation and what percentage value will be treated as a part of the wages. And second, actually, employee contribution or pension. There is no need because pension and the PF is there is a another policy that is going to be you can take the from the code on social security. Now D is important, any conveyance allowance. So you have to make the policy on which percentage and which amount employee is going to get this conveyance allowance. And E, again, very important, because defray special expenses. Now, actually, the special allowance case is coming before the different high court, even the Supreme Court also. Then he clearly stated in para number 14, okay, that whenever any allowances is being paid to the employee, the employer is liable to explain why he is paying the allowances to the employee. So that is why I am saying defray special expenses. Like I'm giving example, if you have provided uniform to the employee, then definitely you are liable to pay the washing allowance. Without providing uniform, if you are paying a washing allowance, then it is a questionable. And another, actually, heat allowance, dust allowance, are so many allowance, or attendance incentive, okay, are the night allowance. So actually, for that, you have to make the policy to prove it before the any court of law. Like by house rent allowance, you have to make the policy for the house rent allowance. And remuneration payable under the award settlement, definitely, actually, any award is given by the court or some settlement is going to be entered. So it is a written up. And then overtime, there is no need for the policy, because the overtime, definitely, either it is paid under the OHS code, so that is will be treated. So I can submit overtime allowance means statutory overtime. Okay. Any commission means incentive. It may be a production incentive, it may be a sales incentive, it may be a data punching incentive, or any other incentive. Okay. The gratuity as per the social security code. Okay. And any retrenchment as per the IR provision. Okay. So now what is going on? The first part, wages, it should be a 50%, and the box, whatever the allowance we have written here, it should be again 50%. If while making the final salary, if the allowance is going to exceed more than 50%, the balance or overflowing wages will go to the part one. Okay. So this is the definition of wages. Now it is going to affect how upon the company. First of all, actually, under the provident fund provision, the first part of the wages, you are liable to deduct provident fund up to the rider limit. Now presently rider is 15,000. Okay. Achha. Now again, ESI purpose, right now, deduction of the wages for the ESI purpose is the whatever the monthly wages is going to be paid to the employee, all remuneration will be treated for deduction of the ESI. Like HRA was also included, overtime is also included, okay, incentive is also included. Now what will happen with the new definition? Now ESI is not payable on house rent, ESI is not payable on overtime, ESI is not payable on commission, ESI not payable on conveyance allowance. Okay. So that's why in company, the coverage will be increased. Okay. Right now, the rider of ESI is 21,000. It means the person who are getting cost to the company or the gross salary, 42,000, they will be covered now under the ESI. Likewise, in the provident fund, the person who is the cost to the company or the gross salary is 30,000. They will also cover under the provident fund. Okay. So these are now another actually bonus, because under the code on wages, the rider has not been fixed by the central government, because the present bonus act clearly says the person who are getting a 21,000 are eligible to the get the bonus, but the calculation of the bonus will be done 7,000 are the minimum wages, whichever is higher. So now the code on wages, abhi right now no rider has been fixed. So the bonus part will also be calculated in the first wages part. Okay. So right by the liability of the company may increase if no rider has been fixed by the central government. Now another gratuity, I can say under the Gratuity Act, abhi to right now, if a person is getting a 1 lakh rupees, so only 20 or 30,000 is going to be fixed as a basic salary. The 70,000 or say 80% are the allowances. So now under the new definition, the total gross salary, at least you have to pay 50% as wages. So the gratuity will also be paid of the 50% of the gross. So liability will also be increased of the company for the old employee. So now the second actually advice like that, okay, when this code, all four code is going to be implemented in your company, you have to make the wage structure from top to bottom. It is not like that these OHS code are the code on wages applicable on the category of the workmen. Okay, so this is very important. And another actually the effect will come on the unused or the accumulated earned leave. Okay, so new definition of base, what will happen? The take home salary, definitely it will reduce, because now employer has to deduct provident fund and ESI on the 50% of the gross salary. And another actually the retirement benefit will be increased in respect of the gratuity, and the bonus is also be increased, liability of the employer if no rider has been fixed by the central government. Okay, but however actually they have already kept this power, anytime the central government having a power to fix the rider under the bonus provision under the social security code. Now implication of the new definition of wages structure, what is actually when the company is going to take a outsourcing like this security housekeeping, so most of the contractor, they are going to bifurcate the minimum wages into different component to reduce the PF and ESI liability. Okay, now what will happen with the new definition, because actually earlier minimum wages excluding the HRA, it was defined under 2H. Okay, now the new definition of the wages, they say clearly excluding HRA. So this is my advice to all the employer that now while giving a contract to the outsourcing company, a specific condition should be put in the invoice or in the contract of contract that no contractor is going to bifurcate the state government minimum wages, because the minimum wages now it is going to decide by the central government or the state government, the two component. One is the basic, another the DA, and DA is going to revise in the month of April and October. So my first advice, you can tell that all outsourcing company, they should not bifurcate the wages. Okay. Otherwise the liability will come on the personal principal employer. Okay. Now registration, what is going, when this OHS code is going to implement, within 60 days, all establishment through this shrimp from the portal, they have to get registered their all establishment as per the rider limit, 10 or more employee. And that registration will be done under Form 1. And that is will be done by all establishment electronically. I can tell that this is Form number 1. This is very detailed form government has made. So all the actually this establishment has to fill all the information to get this application for registration existing as well as a new establishment. Okay, Form 1 under the Rule 3. Okay, so this is a important. So this is the important actually now addition done by the central government. Okay. Now, no employer shall employ any employee without getting his establishment registered under this code. If the registration has not been done within a 16 days, it shall be treated as a violation and penal action will be done by the government or the prescribed authority. Retention of existing registration. What is saying? Already most of the organization or the old organization, they have already registered. So what guideline has been given? Establishment that are previously registered under any central government law shall be deemed to be registered under this code. An employer will not be required to take any new registration. However, he would be required to provide the detail for existing registration to the registering officer within such time as may be specified by the central government or the state government. Because I can tell very important, most of the people they are also knowing are executive, that labor laws is coming under the concurrent list. So the state government as well as the central government both can pass the law. Okay, so what will happen after implementing this OHS code or the all four code, the state government is also going to make their own rule. Okay, so that's why it is a specified in the provision of law. The central government or the state government may come with their own provision of law, okay, under this OHS code and the other all four code. Okay, now notice of commencement and cessation of the operation. As soon as you are going to operate your so what will happen? Notice of commission. Every employer before starting the operation of any industry, trade, business, manufacturing process, means establishment, who are having a 10, okay, is required to send a notice of commencement of operation and shall also intimate the cessation through to authority specified in this regard. But this information only be given on the Shram Subdha portal through. The notice of commencement and cessation of operation shall be sent through electronically as specified by the appropriate government. Okay. So almost actually when I have read this rules and this act, 99% actually everything will come through electronically. Okay. You have to communicate to the authority electronically only. Now duty of employer. This is a very some responsibility has been increased of the employer. What actually ensured that workplace is free from hazard? That was the earlier provision of law. Comply with the occupational safety health standard and declare under section 18. Up now, this is a board that free annual health examination of employer as may be prescribed in Form 4. And Form 4 actually has, it is like just a total medical checkup of the employee who are having a age more than 45. So that is the must. Now actually, this is a Form 4 for which an employer has to pay the all medical expenses for this medical examination. The Form 4 is having a four-page medical examination. Okay, all every blood test, this is a current symptoms of the disease and the review of the medical history and date of examination, physical, weight, height, and this blood test, everything will be included in the this medical, and one copy will also be given to the employee of this medical examination. And second rider has been fixed the issue appointment letter to all employee on his appointment. That is a compulsory. Either if you are going to engage any contractor or on employee, you are bound to give the appointment letter. That format is given under rule. That is under rule 7, letter of appointment to employee under clause F of subsection 1 of the section 6. Okay. And then format actually is given that you have to write the name of the employee, father name. Again, Aadhaar number is now make the compulsory. Okay. And the labor identification LIN number, because I say that labor identification number of now every establishment has to apply. Because what will happen when you are going to register your establishment under the SRM Suvidha portal, you will get the labor identification number. Okay. Then actually universal UN number for the provident purpose or insurance purpose, UN number. Then designation, category of skill, like semi-skilled, unskilled, highly skilled, like that. And date of joining, basic pay, dearness allowance, and then other allowances, means 50% rider. Okay. And avenue for achieving a higher wages and higher position. Then applicability of the social security, PF and ESI, health checkup, broad nature of the duty. Mala, you have to explain that duty. Okay. Any other information. And thereafter, you can make your own terms and condition of the employee. So these are the few. Actually, it is very important. You have to write on the top of the appointment letter. Okay. So now this is a important. Okay. And what actually the rider, second rider has been fixed. As soon as the code is going to be implemented in your industry, then within a 3 month, you are bound to issue the appointment letter. Achha. To provide and maintain safe working environment. That was the earlier provision of law. Ensure to be responsible for the safety, health of employee, workers, and other person on the premises. Maintenance of plant and system of work free from health risk. Arrangement for safe, risk-free handling, storage, transport, article, and substance. And these are the, actually, this is all old provision, but only newly added, only which I have done in the bold, free annual health checkup and issue appointment letter. So this is the responsibility major has been fixed under the OHS code by the legislature. Now, responsibility of employer for maintaining health and safety working condition. Responsibility of employer for maintaining health, safety and working condition under section 23. Number one, cleanliness and hygiene, ventilation, temperature, humidity. These are all actually old provision of law. So I am not going to discuss. There's an environment, dust free, adequate standard humidity, portable drinking water, adequate standard of prevent overcrowding. Okay. This is again, actually, it is all provision right now available under the Factory Act. So every factory is going to make the, or making a compliance of this provision of law. Now, employer duty with occupational safety, comply with the occupational safety health section 80, physical, chemical, biological, any hazards. Norms to assess the hazard to employee exposed to such hazards. Precaution of safe use of the exposure limit. Free medical examination. Other test of employee exposed to the hazards. Hazard evaluation procedure like safety audit, hazards, operational study, and fault-free analysis, etc. So now, what are actually these all, what is the hazardous industry? So everything is available in second schedule of this code. At the last of the this code, you will find second schedule, and whatever the activity which is coming under the hazardous, so that will be mentioned under the code. Okay. Now, notice of accident, I can say only they have taken it from the old factory act, all provision. Okay. Just a manager of the factory is required to send a report, accident causing death or such bodily injury preventing the person injured from working within 48 hours to the authority within such time as prescribed. So under the rule 8 actually, so they have already made and they have taken it from the old factory rules that the whenever death is occurred, you have to inform the district magistrate or the inspector of factory or the chief inspector of factory and the SDM, sub-divisional magistrate like that. Okay. And you have to file, fill the form number 6. Okay. And send to the ESI corporation. If your industry is covered under the ESI, that person also should be covered. And one copy should go to the chief inspector of the factory office. Okay. Notice of dangerous occurrence. The employer shall send a notice to the authority about dangerous occurrence of such nature, whether causing any bodily injury or disability or not within the such time as may be prescribed, and notice of certain disease. Okay. So now actually certain disease actually basically what is the certain disease that is mentioned under the schedule 3rd. First schedule, second and third schedule. Third schedule may actually list of disease. Okay. So these are, they have given a at least 29. Okay. Hazardous, certain disease occurred due to some hazardous chemical. So they have given this list 29. Okay. Now you have to inform or the given notice to the chief inspector of factory or the inspector of the area. It shall be the duty qualified medical practitioner employed in the establishment and to send information about the contacting of occupational disease by an employee to the office of the chief inspector come facilitator. In case of his failure to send, he will be punished 10,000 rupees. Okay. Now, duty of employee, that is actually, it is the newly added provision of law. Okay. Now, if any employee is going to violate these condition, so definitely the employee can also be prosecuted. What actually the employee at the workplace take reasonable care for the health and safety of himself, of other person who may be affected by his act or omission at the work. So employee will also take care while working, comply with the safety and health requirement specified in the standard. Because actually, if the safety officer has made certain safety manual, that is also mentioned under the rule, I will let you know. So the employee has to follow the safety manual while working. If he is going to violate, the employee can also be prosecuted. Cooperate with the employer in meeting the statutory obligation of the employer under this code. If any situation which is unsafe or unhealthy comes to his attention, as soon as practicable, report such situation to his employer. Not willingly interfere with or misuse or neglect any appliance, convenience or other things provided at the workplace for the purpose of securing health, safety, welfare of the worker. Not to do willfully without reasonable cause anything likely to endanger himself or the other, perform such other duties as may be prescribed by the appropriate government. So I can say like that, this is a newly added provision of law and every employee has to follow. So for that actually, the safety manual has to be made and that should be communicated to the employee. Up now, safety and occupational safety survey. The officer authorized by the appropriate government may at normal working time after giving a notice in writing to the employer conduct survey of the factory, mines, and other establishments, the employer and manager is bound to afford all facility for such survey, including facility for examination and testing of the plant and machinery. Okay, whether actually that machinery is perfectly in working condition, no. So that test has to be done by the employer on the interval. Okay, any worker, if it's so required, may be asked to undergo medical examination. It does not mean that if medical examination has been done once in a year, but any time actually, if the employer is feeling that he is not medically fit, he can also direct any employee to go for medical test to furnish such information in his possession which may be relevant for the survey. Any time spent by the workman for undergoing medical examination, etc., shall be deemed to be working hour for him, and he is entitled for wages for such time spent. Okay. Now, safety committee and safety officer. Okay. Now, actually, this they have reduced the rider. Okay. What I am saying, I am coming on that portion. Establishment employing such number of person as may be prescribed would be required to form a safety committee. Where safety committee is going to be formed, any establishment having a 500 or more employee, that company has to keep a safety officer. Earlier, the rider was 1,000. Now, this rider has been reduced from 1,000 to 500. And if any establishment is having a 500 or more employee, then actually, as per the provision of safety committee, that is a as per the rule 19, okay, rule 19, the safety committee will be formed by the establishment, and the chairman will be the head of the unit who is having a control over affairs of that unit. Okay, that will be designated as a chairman, and the safety officer will be a secretary of that committee, and equal number of person from the workmen are nominated by the union, and equal number of will remain from the employer side. Okay. And if there is some women employees also there, then participation of women employee is also compulsory in the safety committee. So what will happen? The factory wherein 500 or more, earlier that rider was 1,000. So this is a newly added factory employee hazardous process within 250 or more, then safety officer will be kept. Okay. And building other construction worker wherein 250 workers, that will be kept as a safety officer, and mine may 100. So now actually manufacturing industry 500, and then hazardous industry only the 50 worker, then you have to keep a safety officer, and building and construction may 250, and mines may 100. So these are the rider has been fixed by the central government through OHS code. Okay. Now, welfare provision. Now I am coming on that washing facility, bathing facility, clock room for male and female separately, sitting arrangement, first aid box, etc. Now, a canteen. This is the rider of the threshold limit has been reduced. Canteen mein. The old provision was saying when any establishment or the factory is having it 250 or more employee, then there was a need for canteen. Now this rider has been reduced from 250 to 100 or more. Okay. Ambulance, that was remains same, 500 and 500. Rest and lunch room, earlier provision under the Factory Act, 150 or more, then there was a need for restroom or the lunch room. Now this rider has been reduced from 150 to 150 to 50 only. And welfare officer, now it has... Hello? Anything else, sir? Anybody's?
In case if we have any queries, please put it in the chat box.
Yes, kindly. Actually, at the end of this session, we will reply all your question and query, okay? Now, welfare officer, the rider has been reduced from 500 to 250, okay? And Krish facility, 30 or more women, now it has to 50, okay? And safety officer, earlier rider was 1000.
Hey, welfare
it has reduced to 500.
That's it.
Sir, any instruction?
So,
go ahead now, sir.
Right. Yes, sir. I have made everybody mute.
Okay, okay, right. Thank you. So now, these are the very important threshold limit has been reduced by the government. Okay. Regarding the safety officer, I have already narrated. Actually, mines, mein, they have already reduced. And this construction, they have also reduced to 50. But for your industry, the rider is 500 now. Daily and weekly hour work. Actually, they have taken a all provision of law from the old factory act, the 8 hours in a day and 48 hours per week. Okay. Now, no worker shall be allowed to work in an establishment more than 6 days in a week. Okay. So after expiry of the 6 days, you're liable to give a holiday. Okay. Power to exempt from the provision of the waste with the appropriate government and compensatory holiday. Owing to such exempting order under section 26(2), if workman is deprived any weekly holiday, he shall be allowed within a month compensatory holiday of equal number to holiday as so deprived. Okay. So actually this earlier provision was also available in the factory act. So nothing has been new added in this provision. Okay. Overtime mein government has changed drastically. Okay. The power to prescribe the total number of overtime vested with the appropriate government. It means actually appropriate government can fix any rider by issuing a notification. Employer can deploy any worker or overtime work only for obtaining the consent of the such worker. Okay. Extra work. Up now, there is no need to take a permission. Okay. Employer can deploy any worker on overtime without obtaining a permission. Because right now, under the Factory Act, there was a need for taking a more than, you can call it 72 per week. Means 48 hours and further 24 hours. And if you want to give a more overtime, then there was a need to take a permission from the state government. Okay. Now, there is no need to take a permission from the state government in case of overtime. Okay. This is a good moment. Achha, the period of overtime shall be calculated on the daily basis or weekly basis, wherever is more favorable to the such workman. Okay. Night shift, provision of the overlapping shift and restriction of the double overtime and notice of the period of work. Achha. Night shift are permitted in the code and that would be any requirement to seek prior approval from the authority as prevented in some state. Okay. Achha. Employer cannot take work by means of system of shift so arranged or more than one relay of worker is engaged in work of the same kind at the same time. Restriction of double employment. Okay. And notice, display notice of the period of working. Actually, you have to put on the notice board the period of shift working. Okay. So, and restriction of double overtime. Isme the rider has been some increased. No worker shall be required or allowed to work in a mine or factory if he has already been working in any other such similar establishment within the preceding 12 months. The reason behind the provision could be an efficiency of the worker will go down because he may be too tired by handling two jobs at the same time. However, the scope of taking a work from same worker on the same day is extended in the code. In the existing Factory Act, Section 60 restricts the double employment for the whole of the day but here the time frame is mentioned is the only 12 hours. Okay. The notice of the period of work has been displayed, showing the clarity for every day, the period during the which worker may be required to work. So actually we have to put the notice board, which worker is coming, which shift, like that. Copy of such notice is required to be sent to the inspector cum facilitator. Any proposed change in the system of work shall be intimated to the inspector cum facilitator, like that. So now actually, before putting in the shift, you are required to tell the employee which shift he is supposed to come. Now, annual leave. Some actually rebate has given to the employee. What rebate has been given? Okay. Now, entitlement, eligibility, condition, and encashment of unavailed leave. Okay. Changed significantly. Eligibility criteria, right now under the FACTI Act, if the employee has not completed 240 days, he is not entitled to get the earned leave. Now this rider of 240 days has been reduced to 180. Okay. In case of new joinee, a working of the 1/4 of the remainder working day of the year. Okay. So now actually reduce the number of days for eligibility, means the government has reduced from 240 to 180 rupees, 180 days now. Achha, entitlement, again, actually no change. For every completed of 20, one earned leave will be given. Okay. So earlier in FACTI Act, this was also law. This has been taken, or same law will also prevail like that. Achha. Period of entitlement, same calendar year. Okay. That is important, because I can say like that, and to clarify to all, under the FACTI Act, the calculation of the earned leave is going to be done from January to February, means calendar year. Now, you have to stop that practice. Now, the earned leave will be calculated of accounting year, because they have already defined the accounting year, means from April to March. So, that's why I have mentioned the same calendar year and subsequent calendar year, major change. Okay. Achha. Maximum earned leave, 30 days earned leave per year. And 30 days earlier bhi tha, ke maximum jo outstanding hogi, employer can keep only 30 days. Now, one rider has been at the bottom. It is very important. Abhi right now, under the FACTI Act, there was no provision for encashment. It was only the management or the company is going to make the law that the unused earned leave will be paid at the end of the year. Here are some company, they are having a policy that the unused earned leave will be paid at the time of retirement. Now that both rider has been finished, now what will happen right now? Exceeding 30 days can be encashed by the employee in the same year. That is important. Now it means unused earned leave over and above the 30 days, you are bound to encash to the employee. Okay. So this is the important rider has been fixed by the government. Achha. And second, actually, you just see the bottom also, there was a dispute is coming before. Holiday intervening the leave are to be excluded from the period of leave so availed. It is again important. Encashment of wages within a 2 working days in case of discharge dismissal. Because why actually I have written 2 days? What is going on when employee is going to be has submitted the resignation, or he has been terminated, or he has been dismissed, or he has been retired? You are bound to pay the wages within 2 days, including the encashment of the leave. Okay. That is the rider has been fixed under the code on wages. Okay. So that's why I have written. Maintenance of register and record. Register are to be maintained in electronic format or otherwise. Okay. But government is going to insist to all establishment that the all format should be maintained electronically. Okay. Work performed by them, number of hours, okay, and day of rest allowed, like that. So actually, this is a, you have to, like in under the Factory Act, earlier we were maintaining the form number 21 and 20. So same way, actually, now we have to maintain same form, okay, and same, actually, we have to maintain the overtime register. So I would like to mention form for the medical form, notice of accident and dangerous occurrence form 6, and register of worker employed in establishment work overtime fine deduction for damages or loss form 8. We have to maintain 8 form, and then actually form number 9, annual return year ending, okay, you have to submit the annual return. That is very exhaustive, okay, given a that 1, 2, 3, 4 pages, okay. And then for the mine, actually, they made a lot of information, exhaustive list they have given. Then this is 11, that 10 jo hai, that for the register for accident and dangerous occurrence, okay, and then 11 register for leave with wages, okay. So like that, actually, you have to maintain certain register and form for the employee. And the base slip to be issued in electronic form or otherwise. Base slip you have to give in form 5 as per the base code. Okay. Return to be filed electronically. You say, I have already narrated in this form. Okay. Now, appointment of inspector come facilitator, base inspection. So what is going on? The major change has been done under this provision of law for doing a inspection. Inspector cum facilitator has been confirmed with wide range of power to inquire into accident. Okay, that is a one power that was also available in the present act. Okay, enter inspect, that is, so all power has been, they have taken from the old act of the Factory Act. Now only the inspection, routine inspection or general inspection will be done by the inspector on the direction of the appropriate government only. So that is the, and that inspection will be done on the base inspection. It means right now, whenever inspector is coming, he is writing some inspection bookman. That has to be discontinued now, okay? Now, a special provision relating to employment of women, that's important, okay? Now, what is going on? Equality for women to work in every sphere. Women have to permit to work in every sector. Okay. But it has to be ensured that provision for their safety is made by the employer and consent of the woman is taken before they work at night. It means actually, present mein, there was a restriction of the state government ke which company can ask the woman to work in the night. Now that rider has been finished. Now every woman, if she's interested to work in the night shift, can also work in the night shift. Okay. Working hour for women, women can also work at night. That is beyond 7 p.m. and before 6, subject to the condition relating to safety, holiday, working hours, and their consent. Okay. Now there is no need to take a permission from the government. That rider has been removed. Okay. A special provision for contact, that is very important provision they have added now. So now actually contact labor definition, a worker employed in or in connection with the work of the establishment by or through a contractor includes interstate migrant worker, but does not include a work other than part-time employee who is regularly employed by the contractor for any activities of his establishment or his employment is governed by mutually accepted standard of the condition of employment, including engagement on permanent basis, and get periodical increment in the pay, social security coverage, other welfare benefit in accordance with the law for the time being in force in such employment. That is, the surveyor or supervisor of the contractor establishment who make visit in the establishment of the principal employer to oversee the working of his contract labor would be outside the ambit of the contract labor. Means the contractor supervisor will not come under this contract labor. Okay. Or the part-time employee will not come under the contract labor. Achha, contractor hai. So that is actually now contractor is treated as an employer. So that's why actually they have defined categorically under this code, defined to one end of the code, relation to establishment means who undertakes to produce a given result for the establishment other than mere supply of goods and article. Means the vendor and the supplier, okay, will not be called as a contractor now. Clearly, it is mentioned, undertake to produce a given result for the establishment other than a mere supply of goods or article of manufacturing to the such establishment through a contract labor or supply contract labor for any work. So it means actually vendors, jo hai, supplier and vendor will not treated now a contractor. A principal employer, it is totally defined, occupier or the establishment will be treated as a principal employer. Now, right now the provision where actually Contract Labor Evolution Act, CLR Act clearly say if any establishment has having it 20 or more, he has to get first registration from the Deputy Labor Commissioner. Okay. Now this rider has been removed permanently. Now only contractor is liable to take the license. First, actually what will happen? If that contractor is having a 50 or more than 50, then he's liable to take a license from the state government, and he can also take a license from the central government for across the country. One license can also be issued through Subdha Shram portal. Okay. So the specific actually license fees has been designed. Procedure for issue of license under subsection 2 of section 48. Now up to 49, okay, no license fees, and 50 to 100, 1000 like that, they have given a maximum fees there 40,000. Okay, now, so registration licensing, registration of establishment, no separate registration. Because right now, actually, there was a need to get registered first self that we want to employ contract labor. Now, there is no need. That rider has been finished now. Licensing of contractor. Contractor is required under Section 11 by paying the fees and security. Okay. Type of license. That is a important. Okay. Work specific license. That will be given by the state government for only concerned work order as specified in the license. Okay. And common license for executing contract work in more than one state or whole of India, pan India basis. That common license. So if contractor is taking a common license, that can be provided this Shram Subdha portal. Okay. He can apply. And the life of that common license will be the 5 years. Okay. License issued under this code valid for 5 years. Thus, no requirement for annual renewal as prevailed in existing system. So this is a very good provision has been added. If a contractor has taken a common license, he can work across country, any establishment, and there is no need to take a license from state government. Or form 4 from the existing employer that has been removed. Achha, welfare facility on contract labor. It shall be the duty of the principal employer to provide welfare facilities specified section 23 and 24. is the responsibility of the now principal employer. Responsibility of the payment of wages, that again actually it is the responsibility first, as a first responsibility goes to the contractor. ठीक है ना? He is liable to pay the wages of their labor through bank transfer only, no cash payment, and inform to the principal employer about such disbursement. When contractor is going to disburse the money, he has to inform, means actually he has to provide the payment sheet to the employer that I have already paid. Or this is also provision that one representative of the principal employer can also be appointed or authorized one representative, and in presence of that representative, salary should be disbursed. Okay. Now, in case failure of the contract to pay the wages or make short payment, the liability shift on the principal employer. Okay, to make the payment of wages in full and unpaid wage. However, the principal employer can recover the same from his contractor from the wage bill or the invoice value. Now, actually, last is very important. Right now, there was no provision to issue a experience certificate. Okay, it was not mandatory. Okay, if any workman is asking, if he is giving, if he does not give, then he cannot force, or there is no violation. Now this rider has been fixed by the central government through this code on OHS code, that every contractor shall on demand issue a experience certificate to the contractor giving the detail of the work performed by him. So this is again important provision of employment with contract labor. Okay, up now section 67.
Yes,
so
if you can sum up in the next 10 minutes and quickly go through the
okay within 10 minutes I'm going to. Okay,
thank you.
The code has bring out certain major change to provision of contract under the that CLR act has been repealed now. Okay, but under this code and automation provision is provided that no employer can engage labor contractor core activities. The provision has been done automatically. Okay, this is important. Like jaise your fertilizer company hai, so you cannot engage the contract labor or core activities. You can only give a contract for the non-core activities, which actually I have explained. Okay, the core activities has been defined and means the primary activities for the which the establishment is set up, okay, and include any activity. So like that, this is a again very good provision has been added. Okay, exception to provision of the employment of contract labor. Principal employer may engage contract labor through a contractor to the any core activities. Up, employer can use contract labor. Even contract what that rider. Normal functioning of the establishment is such that activities ordinarily done through contractor. The activities are such that they do not require full-time worker for the major portion of the working hours in day or for longer period as may be. So the employer can use even a through contractor. Any sudden increase, suppose there is just some demand of your product, but actually that demand is for a particular period or some period. So for excess number of person, you can give on contract. So even for the core activities. So this is again important. Okay. Special provision interstate migrant. Because what any establishment having a 10 or more, he has to register. If he is going to engage any interstate migrant, he has to register on the portal. Base ceiling actually that is a 18,000 per month. Registration of inter-migrant worker and interstate migrant worker may register himself. Well, it means actually if any employee is going to work in any other state, so first of all he has to get registered, and through portal actually you have to see whether if he has registered, then you can recruit. Otherwise you cannot recruit that interstate migrant labor. Facility to interstate migrant, that is important. Okay, to ensure suitable condition of work, such worker having a regard to the fact that he is required to work in the state different from his own state. In case fatal accident or serious bodily injury, any worker report to the specific authority, both state where he reside and the next near and dear. Okay. And to extend benefit of ESI, PF and medical checkup. Achha. Up next, your last mein hai, that is very good. You have to provide the journey allowance also. What actually journey they have to, the employer shall pay to every interested migrant labor in every year lump sum amount of fare to and fro journey to his native place from the place of his employment in manner into account minimum service for entitlement periodically and class of travel. So the rule actually has been made second class sleeper. You have to provide the once in a year. Okay. That has been mentioned in the. So it is specifically mentioned under the rule. Okay. Now a special provision for factory. Okay. That is a old provision of law that has been taken from the submission of the building plan, site plan, license and renewal. Every year you have to do and prepare on the site emergency plan, plan for disaster control. Actually, this all provision of law they have taken from the factory act. Power to make exempting rules. Okay. The appropriate government in respect of the any provision of law, they can also exempt for implementing. Now, offense, actually, this is a, again, if employer or employee is going to violate the provision of this code, then the penalty or the fine may be extended 20,000 to 20 lakhs. That is important. And the punishment can also be done up to 3 years. So that penalty has been enhanced as a cooling period means actually repetition will not be treated if the occurrence has been done after the 3 years, so that should not be treated as a repeated offense. Okay. Limitation of the period before launching any prosecution, inspector is required to give an opportunity to the employer in respect of the compliance. When he is going to do inspection, he has to issue a show cause notice, and within 30 days, employer has to reply of that show cause notice. Okay. So, like that, actually, offense has been. And the penalty provision has been drastically made. Up now, what will happen? There is a composition offense. Certain offense is going to be compound. Kaun se hai? That if long list of non-compoundable offense, theek hai na? The list has been given at the end, ke, which is going to be compoundable, which is not going to non-compoundable offense. But actually, the rider has been fixed. Compoundable offense shall be sum equal to 50% maximum fine provided for such penalty for a sum of 75% if such offense is provided under the code. The amount of composition shall be credit to the social security fund. Now, whatever the penalty, that amount will go to the social security fund established for unorganized labor. Okay. Now, who is going to decide compounding? That actually basically the joint secretary rank. Inquiry of the offense by officer and power to impose penalty. So under secretary to the government of India, equal level will be notified in the state government to this compounding the offense or to impose the this burden. Okay. To reduce the burden on subsidized judiciary, the power to impose the penalty fine has been given to the officer not below rank the under secretary. Okay. So like that, actually under secretary is going to decide these all matter. Okay. Up now, this is again, they have taken from the jurisdiction of the civil court barred power to exempt the special case and power to exempt during the public emergency. Okay. So now what will happen for implementing this code on OHS to remove the difficulty and which arises in giving effect to the provision of this code, provided that every such order must be made before the expiry period of 3 years from the commencement of this code. Means another 3 years rider has been fixed. If there is a difficulty for implementing this provision of the law, so basically the government has to issue a notification and order. Okay. Now, when this code is going to implement, as per the provision of 143, all the 13 codes will be repealed. Okay. So this is the my presentation in respect of the OHS code. And if any participant is having a question, definitely I will try to reply. Okay. Thank you, madam. Over to madam. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible, sir. Can I get to take the questions which are there? So can I take the few questions?
Definitely. Yeah. Chat box, actually only 3 questions, I hope so.
Yeah, so there are 3 questions, sir. We will first try to work on
impact of
this, and then we can ask others to speak. So the first question is, what is the revised threshold for additional requirement for welfare and safety officer?
Safety officer, actually there is a for manufacturing industry, the safety officer should be appointed when any industry is having a 1,000 or more. Now this rider has been reduced from 1,000 to 500. For construction industry, it has been reduced to 250. Okay. For mining, it has reduced to 100. And hazardous industry is only 50.
Okay.
Okay. The safety next officer is required.
Okay. So the next question is impact on union. One, working of 12 hours a day, and two, allowed companies with up to 300 workers to fire workers or shut plants without prior approval of the government from government.
The question is not clear, but in respect to the 12 hours working, I can make it very clear, because this dispute is coming across the country that the now government has increased the working hours from 8 to 12. It is not correct. The working hour of the employee will remain 8 hours, but spread over its 12 hours. Okay. So operating hour is only 8 hours, which is specifically mentioned in the rules also. Let me read clearly. Okay. Rule 28 clearly say no worker shall be required allowed to work in the establishment more than 48 hours in a week. Means 8 chhang 48. Okay. So 8 hours se zyada ki working nahi hai. Okay.
Sir, and regarding the 300 workers. Company can shut anytime by the employer regarding
you are talking about the IR.
Yes, sir.
So actually we are yes, very correct, sir. Dekhe, this issue, this IR, we are going to take on 15th. But since you have asked this, I am going to reply it.
Okay.
In respect of the layoff, in respect of the closure, in respect of the retrenchment. Okay. Yeah.
Yes,
if
sir.
Any establishment is having a 300 or less than 300, okay, there is no requirement to take a permission from the state government. There is a specific law under the Industrial Relation Act. Okay.
Yeah. But this is
there is no need. But only the rider. Please, kindly.
It is your government has given the tremendous amount of flexibility to the employer.
देखिए जी कि एक्चुअली विच आई कांट आई एम नॉट ए
नो नो सर दिस इज जस्ट माय व्यूज व्हाट आई एम डिस्कसिंग
दैट्स करेक्ट देखिए दिस राइडर हैज बीन फिक्स्ड एंड रिगार्डिंग दिस 300 आई कैन लेट यू टेल यू वेरी क्लियरली दिस राइडर वाज आल्सो अवेलेबल 300 इन उत्तर प्रदेश
Yes, yeah, yeah.
Rider was also available in the Rajasthan also.
Rajasthan, MP and everywhere. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But now this rider has been applicable across the country to easy doing business only. Okay. Ease doing business. Okay. So you are correct 100%. This rider has been fixed by the legislature in the IR code.
Okay. So this will be easy for the employer to dismissal or any...
And I think that your... your actually one question is also that the working hour has been increased from 8 to 12.
Yes,
no,
yes, 12.
It is not
is
like
it
that.
In the code,
it
sir?
Is not like that.
Because it is in the code.
No. No, it is not in the code also.
Okay. That's
there is a confusion. Therefore, I would, since you are asking,
yes.
They, you note down rule yes. 28.
Okay.
Note down kindly.
Please.
Okay, na?
Yeah.
You note down rule 28, which clearly say that 48 hours in a week.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
But 8 hours per day.
Yeah.
But spread over 12 hour means actually a worker can also work within 12 hours, but operating hour will be a 8 hours. Means after 4 hours. He has to allow to take a rest and another actually 4 hour can also be used. ठीक है ना? Means मतलब 12 घंटे में 8 घंटे ही काम करना पड़ेगा.
लेकिन उसको वो 4 घंटा overtime के रूप में दिया जाएगा या continue the normal duty?
No. Rest दिया जाएगा उसको.
अच्छा.
Can we go to the next question?
Thank you, sir.
So the next question. What is the provision for revision or updating of shift allowance? How many hours one can do overtime after his normal duty hours?
Actually, that rider has been removed now. Pehle actually rider, madam, actually this was the specifically fixed ke 72 hours tha. 48 hours normal working and 24 hours in a week. Now this rider has been removed by the central government but this power has been given to the appropriate government. They can issue a notification. Okay. Like this.
So the next question is additional safety officer on how much headcount is required or if any industry have 2000 employees, then how many safety officers, welfare officers are required?
Welfare officer, actually, I would say that I have already shared that site. I would like to share again. Kindly see this rider. Canteen, actually, madam, there was a rider 250.
Okay.
Now it has reduced from 250 to 100. Canteen is must. Ambulance room 500. That was remained same. Restroom, actually, earlier, right now there is a provision 150. Now you have to provide the restroom and the lunch room when you are going to employ 50 or more employee, okay? Welfare officer, it was a 500. Now it is reduced to 250.
Okay.
You have to keep the welfare officer when strength is going 250. And which facilities is 50, 30 to 50. But only the value addition has been done by the central government. Now, instead having a on creech facility, you can also provide through private organization means in industrial area when the establishment is having a 50-50-50 like coffee industry hai, toh particular distance. Distance has not been under the rule. It is a clearly the distance within a 5 kilometer, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, that will be notified by the state government or the appropriate government.
Okay, sir.
अच्छा एक चीज और है मैडम दैट जो क्रीज फैसिलिटी है दैट इज अगेन एम्बिग्युटी इज गोइंग ऑन एम्प्लॉय की डेफिनेशन है मींस दे हैव नॉट डिफाइंड के इफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैविंग ए 50 और मोर फीमेल एम्प्लॉय नो एम्प्लॉय ओके बट इन द रूल एक्चुअली दे हैव दैट फीमेल एम्प्लॉय सो सम क्लेरिफिकेशन विल कम व्हेन द रूल विल बी नोटिफाइड Some objection has been put before the government. Either employee or the female employee. Employee which employee is going to count for the purpose of this rider crash facility?
Hello, madam. Regarding the safety officer, for each 500, if the employees are more than 500, for each 500, we have to deploy one safety officer or not?
Actually, that will be, वैसे तो right now, what is going on, more than 500, but two safety officer, that notification will be notified by the state government. Abhi, okay. Still now, there is no provision under okay. the act. Okay. Only the rider has been fixed that 500 or more, one safety officer has to be appointed. But provision will also come 500 per one, 1000 per two, or more than 2000 per three, like that. This provision is also available in the FACTI Act right now.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Right.
Sir, we would like to thank you, sir, for giving us a detailed inputs regarding this very crucial topic. Probably by April, we will get a complete understanding. But okay. creating that knowledge base was very much essential for our, okay. all our employees.
Okay.
So, Gupta, sir, thank you very much for providing all the details. Would like to also extend a thanks to all the participants who joined this webinar and could get a complete detailed understanding about the changes in the code. Today, we had this inputs about the OHC, Occupational Health and Safety. We have another webinar on 15th where Mr. Gupta will be facilitating us again, once again. So, would request all the participants to join the webinar on 15th. Gupta sir, thank you to you. And okay. I shall announce the webinar as closed.
Okay. And I am assuring that I will also provide this PPT.
Yeah, that would be really good.
You can also give this all PPT to your all participants. Okay.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much for that. Yeah.
I have already even sent the reading material.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You can also distribute among the okay. participants. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.